Hi, I don't know about you, but I am so ready to pack a bag and head off anywhere warm. We've had a lot of snow and ice and really cold weather this year in Nashville, and enough already. I'm ready to head off and travel somewhere. Can't though, because I haven't had the vaccine. Places aren't open up yet. I'm trying to be safe. So in the meantime, I'm going to travel through books. The five that I've listed here today are all fiction books. And they take you to places like Australia, France, Ireland, England, and I hope you can find one that you enjoy, curl up with it, and head off in your imagination at least. Hi, my name is Pam Lamp. I write a blog called Who I Met Today, where I interview people from all walks of life and also talk about food, books, relationships, and fun places and things to do. The first book that I highly recommend is called The Chanel Sisters by Judith Little. And you do not have to be a fashionista to love this book. It's not all about fashion. It's a story of the two Chanel sisters as told through the point of view of Antoinette. It's really an interesting tale when you keep in mind that the sisters grew up in an orphanage. Very, very, very poor, and it just makes the success that they ultimately achieved even more impressive. They even were able to flourish during the war, and Antoinette played a huge role in helping her sister Coco build their empire. So I hope that you enjoy that. The second book that I've listed is The Guest List by Lucy Foley. That one came out last year, and it's about a group of privileged young people that meet on a very creepy island in Ireland for a wedding. Lots of twists and turns and things you don't see coming. Someone ends up dead. And what I really liked about the book, besides the plot, of course, is that the chapters are short. So you can finish a chapter and say, I'll just read one more before I turn out the light. But I like books with short chapters that keep things moving along. So if you read that, I'd love to know what you think of it. The next one is The Paris Library by Janet Skeslien-Charles. And this was such a beautiful story about a part of history that I knew nothing about. It talks about the American Library in Paris. It's based on the truth, and the courageous librarians that kept the library open to their subscribers during the war. The library had been banned. Jewish subscribers were not allowed to go in there. And during the war, these librarians actually delivered books to those individuals so that they could keep reading. Just a great story. And I hope you like that as much as I do. The next one is The Midnight Library by Matt Haig. And I have to laugh when I think of this one because I'm in a virtual book club. Actually, it's through another writer who writes for 60andMe. And if you're interested in being a part of that book group, send me an email and I'll be happy to connect the two of you. But anyway, the Midnight Library, when the woman in our book club proposed this as our next read, she described it as time travel, science fiction, alternate universe, all the things I typically detest in a book. And I thought, oh brother, I'm not going to like this one. But it had great reviews by the New York Times. And so I thought, I'm going to give it a try. That's what book clubs are for, to encourage us to read things we wouldn't otherwise pick out on our own. Expands our world a little. And after a couple chapters, I still wasn't sure. And then it hit its stride, and I just loved it. It's kind of a It's a Wonderful Life story. If you've ever seen that movie at Christmas time, it talked about the characters' regrets and mistakes and the what ifs, and very thought-provoking, and got me to thinking about my own life and the what ifs that I'm always good at churning in my head. The last book is called The Good Sister by Sally Hepworth. And I'm so excited that I discovered this author. She's an Australian author. She has a huge fan base, has written lots of books, and this one was just great. It was about two sisters. One had controlling issues, the other had hypersensitivity issues. She was very, very sensitive to anyone touching her or loud sounds or smells, and just about a sister relationship and setting boundaries and a mystery woven through that. So I actually, as soon as I finished it, I looked up other books that she has written, and I also read The Mother-in-Law and highly recommend that. I'm going to be reviewing that in the coming months too. So anyway, I hope you'll read the story. I hope you'll let me know what you're reading now, and maybe tune into my blog too. Subscriber information is at the bottom of the story. So thanks very much and happy reading.